feet.
Let me know.
We now have the final of the second chance, DYP. That's Battle Gorman and Ken Oda on the right side, and that's Art Mariano, Kathy Nethery on the left. 1-1 here in game number one as Battle Gorman sets it up. And O'Gorman fires it home.
Ready?
Ken Oda will pick up the loose ball here. 1-2 out of three match to determine the DYP, the last chance DYP winner. Art Mariano hammers that one home. It's 2-2. O'Gorman's going to get a possession. He'll look for the lead. Just 1-2 out of three match, and he finds the short side. Ganoda just getting it out, getting it to his partner. And O'Gorman able to trickle one through. Pat with that rolling pole shot blocked by Nethery. O'Gorman will get another chance to give his team a 4-2 lead. And he does. Take this one away from Mariano. 4-2 lead for O'Gorman and Oda. And that one up the table towards the goal, kept out by Nethery. The shot attempt blocked by O'Gorman comes back to Nethery. And O'Gorman with the steal. Pat can win this opening game. Remember, all the open action will continue tomorrow as O'Gorman wins game number one with that pull shot. He and Oda up 1-0. Tomorrow, early afternoon, we'll have the rest of the open singles competition for you. And a little later in the afternoon, the open doubles. We'll bring you all the matches remaining in those two events tomorrow afternoon here at netfoos.tv. Go. Second game underway. Oh, Dub makes the block up into the air and off the table. Kenny was there.
Ready.
Ganoda putting it back into play. Turns it over. Mariano. Yeah. No score here in game two. The last chance DYP final.
Ready.
The old boys, O'Gorman and Oda on the right. Art Mariano, Kathy Nethery on the left. This is Mariano setting up his snake shot now. You can shoot the snake in this, of course, in this event. Just not in the open events. Not in open doubles, open singles, or open mixed. Mariano slams it home to that near side. They're going to get a switch. Mariano to go, Nethery to forward. Picked up here by O'Gorman. Mariano firing that one up the table. O'Gorman picks it up with his five. Brushes it through, can't connect. And then sent into the goal by Nethery with her five. Kathy, a fighter, no doubt about that. And O'Gorman cuts the lead in half. Back to forward comes Mariano. And we're going to get a timeout here. Put back into play by Mariano. Art has it taken away by Oda. That ball up the table will spin back to Mariano on the five. Art advanced it and came back to it. And it's O'Gorman trying to pass down the middle. Nethery in possession. Intercepted by O'Gorman. Nice pass down the middle by Pat. But he sprays the shot wide of the goal. Nethery turning it over. But taking it back and making a nice save. Good job by Kathy. Always hustling back there. Or at forward when she plays that position. Shot on goal. The ball comes back to O'Gorman. And then it's sent into the goal with the five. And take it away here by Pat O'Gorman. Able to get this one through. Taken away by Nethery. One game to nothing lead for O'Gorman and Oda, tied at two. O'Gorman. And Nethery there again. And down the middle comes Nethery. It's 3-2. And Kathy also making the block here. Mariano finesses this one to his three rod. Try to take it out to that far side. Blocked by Oda, it bounces back to Mariano. And Oda again there. And that one back into the goal and in. It's 4-2. Now you get a switch here. Oda to forward in an offensive situation. And O'Gorman to goal. Been a while since Pat had scored from his three run. Looked like he might have been running out of gas just a little bit. So they bring Oda up there. And Kent's going to get an opportunity. Here comes Beck with that quick pull kick. Nethery takes it away. Kathy. And Mariano able to dig it out. So Mariano and Nethery just a goal away from sending this last chance DYP final to a final game, and we're going to get a timeout here. Into play here by Mariano. Chance here to send it to a third and final game for Art. Sets it up. Tried to come near side. That went up into the air and off the table. Ball here and has it stolen away by O'Gorman. Nethery with a shot up the table and another chance here for Mariano to send it to game number three. Art misfired here, and Oda able to pick it up. Back to to Mariano again. Nice switch and block there by Kenny. Gorman, who has been blocked on his last 8 or 10 in a row. Another one here. Nethery really working hard defensively. Gorman wide of the goal. Rebound back to Pat. Another shot. This time, Nethery there. And that one back into the goal against Kathy Nethery. It's 4-3. Turned over here by Oda. Mariano, yet another chance to send it down to a final game. And he's able to get that one through. It's one game apiece. All right, so the DYP, the second chance DYP, has come down to one final game. Gorman will pick it up here. Pat has had a lot of possessions. And able to stroke this one home. One nothing lead for O'Gorman and Oda. Mariano crisply through the lane. And stroking it home here. So the scoring's starting to pick up. It's 1-1. Pass here by Mariano, starting to pick it up. He's made his last two. But misfires here. Gorman able to get it through and go to get a laugh out of that, and then pounding it home here is O'Gorman.
Ready.
2-1 lead. Mariano, quick shot near side, comes back to Nethery. Kathy sends one up the table. Oda digs it out. Kenny with a pass attempt, gets it through, and it's picked up by O'Gorman, who sends that one towards the goal. Oh, a nice pass here by Oda. See if O'Gorman takes a little more time. No, he doesn't. He doesn't need to. It's 3-1. Nice pass. Nice shot. And they're up by 2. And a timeout. Oda able to pick up the loose ball here and send it forward. Mariano picks it up here on his three rod. And he's able to hammer that one home with authority. Getting a little heated down on table number one. There was some discontent on the left side of the table, and it got transferred over to the other side a little bit. And stroking it home here is O'Gorman. It's match point. Mariano really pounded that last shot, and perhaps there was a bit of a recoil, and perhaps not. Hard to tell from here. Either way, it's match point. Taken away here by Mariano. And that one's going to spin back to Oda after the block. And another nice pass here. And O'Gorman can win it. And there it is. In three games, Pat O'Gorman and Ken Oda defeat Art Mariano and Kathy Nethery to win the Second Chance DYP. We've got some qualifying round action in the No Pro Doubles event on table number one. Mike Kyrus, Pat O'Gorman on the right. Jim Runyon, Gina Davis on the left. It's just one game to seven. We're still qualifying in this event. I believe it's fourth round qualifying action. Mike Kyrus, who won the Pro Singles Championship earlier today over his partner, Pat O'Gorman. Gina Davis. I think we'll see Gina later as well in the DYP final. She's playing with Tony Spredeman. Kyrus loses it to Runyon. See much bumping there either, but Runyon said he'll watch it. That's usually the best response. If someone wants to call you on something or warn you on something, just say you'll watch it. Pat O'Gorman, who's been playing forward all weekend, is back there at the goalie position here. Kyrus has it taken away by Runyon. Jim able to advance it through the lane. Jim Runyon from snake shot position. He'll come to the near side, taken away by O'Gorman. And Kyrus with the block, and then eventually the pickup on his three rod. He'll shoot against Gina Davis as we still look for our first score of this qualifying round match. Gina gets out there to make the block. Stroking it home here is Runyon. It's 1-0. Nothing lead for Runyon and Davis. Banked off the outside wall. It would sort of slid along that wall. Picked up here by Davis. Gina fires a pull shot on goal. Picked off by O'Gorman. bounces after the pull kick. Davis will put it back into play. Mike Kyrus. Can't hold on to the pass. Picked up here by Runyon. And Jim's going to get another possession. And he's going to fire it home. 2-0 lead, and we get a switch. O'Gorman moving back to forward. Kyrus to goal. And that one knocked down by Runyon. Back to Kyrus, who sends that one up the middle, angled towards the goal of the three by O'Gorman, and Davis grabs the rebound. Qualifying round action in the No Pro Doubles event. Still some big open doubles matches to come later this afternoon. Pick it up. Pat's had a good weekend. He's played very well all weekend long. This is the final day of action here from Palm Springs. And, Runyon makes the steal. Jim tried to come back to that near corner, blocked away by Kyrus. Runyon again. And stroking it home far side is Jim Runyon. It's 3-0. O'Gorman trying to brush it up. 3-0 lead for Runyon and Davis. Runyon able to pick up the loose ball here after the pull shot by Davis. And that one angles up where he catches it with the middle end. Things going right now for Runyon and Davis as Jim looks for a 4-0 lead. And finds it. O'Gorman trying to get something going. Been a lot of drop passes on the right side by both Kyrus and O'Gorman. Runyon brushing it up. And stroking it home. It's 5-0. I think that team there, O'Gorman and Kyrus, one of the pre-tournament favorites, one of the top three or four, certainly, you would think, in this No Pro Doubles event, but they're down 5-0 to Runyon and Davis in qualifying round play. O'Gorman will try to advance it again. And has it stolen, and then eventually it's Kyrus picking up the rebound. O'Gorman will get his first possession on the three rod. And that one wide, right back towards the goal, where it's picked up by Kyrus. Runyon with possession on the five. And now on the three. It's 6-0. And we get another switch on the right side. 6-0 lead for Runyon and Davis. You know, I don't recall ever actually having said that before. 6-0 lead. But we don't often do matches that are simply one game to seven. However, it is 6-0 in this qualifying round match. Banged off the inside wall by O'Gorman and picked up by Runyon, who has played himself quite a match. And he's got a chance to win it right here. Jim Runyon. And it's over. Jim Runyon and Gina Davis defeat Pat O'Gorman and Mike Kyrus in this qualifying round match. We've got more action in the No Pro Doubles event. It's another qualifier as we begin to determine who will be the teams that do qualify. There you saw James Castillo, Calvin Chan. They were on the right. That is Clint Coyne and Kelly Wyant on the left. One game to seven as we are winding down our qualifying round. Wyant has that one blocked by Castillo. Comes back to Kelly. Nice pass here by Castillo. And Castillo coming back, soaking that one home. James, very talented player out of Northern California. Any no pro event, as a coin able to angle that one in. Clint, the veteran player out of Maryland, although originally out of Southern California. Castillo shooting the bump kick and finding the short side of the goal. Always fun to see this particular series. We talked about it earlier in the weekend. Last weekend, we got to see Lim Lee, the outstanding player from Louisiana, shooting that particular shot. Nobody does it better than him. Castillo's got a pretty good one as well. It's that bump kick where you set it up well out off the wall, actually pretty much in front of the corner of the goal, and then you can hit that short dink, or you can hit the long, or even the split. And you can even come back with a slingshot if you want, and we may see that from James as this match goes on. Castillo and Chan leading 2-1 here in this game to seven. Here it is again, looking at the short and tried to angle that one. Wyant able to take it away. Kelly up the table, and again it's Castillo who picks up the loose ball, this time to the snake shot for James. And that one blocked up into the air and off the table. Interesting bit of trivia for those of you who care. The team on the left side of your screen, that's Clint Coyne and Kelly Wyant. The two, actually three, highest finishes for me in an open event back during my early pro career were with those two players. A third in open doubles with Clint Coyne and a couple of thirds in mixed doubles, open mixed, out on the major tour with Kelly Wyant. So there you go. And stroking it home, here is Castillo. It's 3-1. Boy, James really got that one out there. Looking very much like Lim Lee, the equal of. That was a great shot. Clint Coyne still shaking his head about it. Here's Clint, who played goalie for a young push kicker way back when we were all very young. Not that we aren't still young. If you play foosball, you're forever young. And coming back again is Castillo with a roar. That is impressive. It's 4-1. Calvin Chan. Hey, is he Cal? Cal, of course, working with Warrior Table Soccer. One of the tournament directors here this weekend. And Castillo picks it up here. Boy, James just continues to get better and better as a player. And here's the bump kick. How can you not look at the long here? Nope, goes with a short dink, and it's blocked by Wyant. And Kelly to the back of the goal with a push shot. Kelly, a very good scorer back there, always has been. Ed Castillo with another possession. See what James does here. Fires it home. Boy, he's feeling it with that bump kick. Five-two lead for Castillo and Chan. Clint tried to take it out of the far side. Calvin Chan with the block. And Castillo will get another chance. James tried to go to the short side. Wyant got a man on it. Rebound comes back to Calvin. Wyant hustles after it, but it's going to come to Castillo, who went with something quick. Kelly fires that one just wide. Clint can't quite grab it. It angles towards the goal. Kept out by Calvin Chan. Final day action from the Warrior Desert Classic here in Palm Springs, California. Another clear, bright, sunny, extremely hot day here in the California desert. Still 5-2. This is either the final round of qualifying or there'll be one more. The top teams will advance. I'm thinking it'll be the top eight teams, but we'll find out after this. Wyant puts a shot on goal, and Coyne picks up the rebound. Clint will set up the snake. And find the hole down the middle. It's 5-3. Castillo. Tried to go short. Wyant was there. Sometimes I think with that bump kick, I think you can overuse the inside. Of course, you want to set him up, but when you can go long the way that Castillo can and has during this particular game, I think then you just need to slow it down, delay your takeoff, take 6, 7, 8 seconds while faking behind the ball or next to the ball, as we see Lim Lee do and we've seen James Castillo do, and just hammer some longs at different intervals. Kept out here by Wyant. Kelly's shot attempt. Castillo able to pick it up. Still 5-3. Kelly Wyant again. And Coyne now can pull his team within one. Clint Coyne fires it home. It's 5-4. And we're going to get a timeout here. Castile will put it into play. That big lead has evaporated down to just a goal. Castile looking to remedy that as he sets up the bump kick. And they try to go long. Chan able to pick it up here. Clint taking a closer look. He did that wall pass that slid between his man and the wall. Deal. Tic-tacking. And there's Wyant again. Clint Coyne now can tie this qualifying round match up at 5. Coyne tried to come near side, taken away by Calvin Chan. James does here. Gonna go with a tic-tac. Now he's setting it up in bump kick position. And Masuda, rather Wyant, has begun to really get a read on it. But Castillo had it, then lost it. Castile can win it here, and he does. James Castile and Calvin Chan to beat Clint Coyne and Kelly Wyant in this qualifying round match. We have more action in the No Pro Doubles event here at the 2015 Warrior Desert Classic. It's a quarterfinal round. James Castile, Calvin Chan on the right side of your screen. Phil Perros, William Haberman on the left. We're underway here in game number one, with Castillo striking first to give his team the early lead.
Right.
match, best two games out of three. The winner will advance to the semifinals. Scheduled for 4 o'clock today in the Pacific time. That would be 7 p.m. on the East Coast as Castillo sends up the bump kick and strokes it home. It's 2-0. James really shooting it well. Scheduled for 4 o'clock, the open doubles event will continue with two semifinals and a final here on table number one. So set your clocks for that. That's going to be some great action. Names like Trevor Park, Todd Lafredo, Tony Sprademan involved with that one. Here's Castillo. Trying to go to that short hole, and Haberman able to get on it. That's William Haberman and Phil Parros on the left. James Castillo, Calvin Chan on the right. Quarterfinal action in the No Pro Doubles event. Chan with a delayed release pull kick, nicely done on goal. Haberman with a rebound. Castillo with another possession here. James likes to go with a quick one once in a while. And there's that stroking bump kick again. 3-0. And that one's going to get through to Castillo. And it's 4-0. And a timeout.
Hey, keep it down over there.
Nothing lead for Castillo and Chan. It's been all James Castillo so far with a bump kick. Chan tried to come down the middle, blocked by Parros. Cal wide of the goal. Arrow shooting the snake. And Chan with the block. Rebound caroms back to Phil Parros. The middle, caught again by Castillo, who can close out game number one as he sets up the bump kick. Tic-tac to the far side, James again, and there's Haberman to take it away. And Parros with a retrieval. Trailing 4-0, Phil Parros setting it up. Taken away by Calvin Chan. Another opportunity here for Parros.
Corner. It's 4-1. But James Castillo, who has been the star of the match so far, will get a chance again to put away this opening game. Maybe he takes a little more time here. And finds the hole down the middle. It's 1-0. We've got a switch on the left side as William Haberman moves to forward. Joe Perros is going to see if he can do something with James Castillo's three rod. And Haberman and Perros on the scoreboard first here in this second game. Castillo now will shoot against Perros. James.
Angles it to that short corner. What a great possession there. And really took his time and hit that short side of the goal, which is only going to help him in the long run to hit that bump kick long. Castillo, as good as his three has been, his five has been equally good. And stroking it home. It's 2-1. Unstoppable right now. James Castillo. Another possession. It's 3-1. Look at him go. On fire. And again. Wow. It's match point. Not much you can say if you are Haberman and Perros. Just a great performance by James Castillo. Intercepted here by Haberman. Haberman and Perros, I think, have had maybe a total of three possessions on the three roll during the course of this match. Castillo has had probably 10 or 12. And stroking it home here is Haberman to cut the lead to 4-2. It remains match point for Castillo and Chan. Bill Perros. And Castillo can put it away right here. As he sets it up, resets it. Tried to come down the middle, blocked by Perros. Rebound comes back to Castillo on the five. And James passed it, but couldn't hold on to it. Pounded on goal by Perros. Chan setting it up on that far goal line. Haberman now can cut the lead to one, and then he loses it back to Chan. Galvin up the middle, and Castillo able to pick it up on his five. Will shoot for the win once again against Phil Perros. James Castillo. Try to go to the short side. Perros got a man on it. Tough to stay home when Castillo has been hitting the long the way he has, but Perros did. And now Haberman able to make the steal. Remains 4-2 here in the second game. One game to nothing lead for Castillo and Chan. James swings and misses there. A little bit lucky to get it back. And again, he'll set it up for the win. And there it is. What a performance by James Castillo as he and his partner, Calvin Chan, win to advance to the semifinals of No Pro Doubles. We have more No Pro Doubles action for you down on table number one. Steve Corioso, Dana Thompson on the right side. This is a semifinal. And on the left, Al Najjar, Tom Mosher. We are underway here in game number one. Best two games out of three. The winner will advance to the final. Still upcoming tonight, more action not only in the open division, but also in the pro division and the No Pro division as well. Corioso working hard defensively. Najjar able to get it through. And Al will either shoot a pull shot or he'll shoot a front pin. He's going to shoot the pull here, it would appear, and he's going to score it. Of course, we've talked about Al Najjar, who the former pro player from the 90s, out of Southern California, who then went back to his home country, Syria, for must be close to 20 years now, at least 15 to 17 years. Went back there and lived, but then was forced to leave because of the war-torn conditions in Syria, and has come back to this country the last couple of years and is now getting back into the sport and playing very well here this weekend. He still has it. Although, you know, once you become a pro player, you always sort of have it there somewhere, at least mentally. Now, physically, of course, you may be a little bit behind, but mentally, you know what it takes to win. And I think that's what we're looking at with Al Najjar. The physical stuff will come back. The mental stuff is there. And right now, the physical's in pretty good shape as well, as he's 2-for-2, and it's 2-0. So one of the neat stories here this weekend is the return of Al Najjar. And this was a guy during the 1990s who was a very good pro player. Had some decent finishes in open events. Out on the professional tour. That's Tom Mosher back there in the goalie position. There you see Tom with the glasses, always with the sunglasses. Tom has been a familiar face on the Pro Tour for many years out of the state of New York. And he is a New Yorker.
Just 1 second. I put my cell phone there because they say they never lost it.
That's a timeout, right?
Timeout. Sorry, guys.
So is that one timeout or?
Well, they go to the stage. I don't know, you want to call a timeout? Is that timeout?
Yeah, timeout.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yep.
Tom Mosher will put it back into play after the timeout. Dana Thompson with a nice save. Dana out of Colorado. Steve Corioso from Northern California, Gilroy. And whenever we talk about Steve Corioso, we talk about Gilroy, the former, I think, garlic capital of the world. I think a lot of those garlic farms are now subdivisions up there, but Steve will set up the pull shot. And picked up here by Mosher. 2-0 lead here in the first game for Najjar and Mosher. The winner of this one will advance to the no-pro final. Banked off the outside wall and in by Mosher. It's 3-0. Steve Corioso, a former world senior doubles champion. And by world, I mean ITSF multi-table world champion. Went over to France a few years ago with Steve Morey and won that title. Tried to slice this pull shot down the middle. Steve, throughout his career, has been predominantly a goalie. He's played with some of the great players from the Bay Area like Adrian Zamora. And another bank here by Mosher. It's 4-0. Corioso and Thompson down early here in this semifinal match. Corioso has partnered up with names like Adrian Zamora, Scott Stewart, another former great player out of the Bay Area. Najjar has it blocked and taken away by Thompson. 4-0 here in this first game, and Tom Mosher has contributed heavily with two outside banks, both a little different. Corioso will get a possession here. Steve still looking to give his team a goal here in this opening game, but Mosher there to take it away. And fires this one down the middle and in. What a performance by Tom Mosher in that opening game as he scores 3 from goal. Najjar and Mosher lead 1-0 after a 5-0 victory. Second game underway, put into play by Corioso. Steve trying to get something started offensively, and that's a good start as he fires that one into the goal with a 5. Rush through here by Corioso. And Steve Kant has had a little trouble executing so far from that pull shot set. Mosher, who has scored three, sends that one towards the goal. And Thompson to the short corner with a pull shot. Nicely done by Dana. It's 2-0. Nothing lead for Corioso, and now make it 2-1 as that pass angles in. Corioso tried to go through the lane twice, blocked by Najjar and then grabbed by L off the back wall. And the rolling pull shot ties it up. Corioso nicely along that near wall. The winner of this one will advance to the No Pro Doubles final as Corioso sets it up. And has it blocked and saved by Mosher. Tom, big attempt towards the goal. Rolls to a stop. Najjar helps Thompson put it back into play. And Dana will set up a pull shot. Steve Corioso, unable to connect here. He and his partner Thompson tied up at two with Najjar and Mosher. Tom tried to pound the bank. It spins forward to the five of Al Najjar, who can't connect on the bounce pass. Najjar and Mosher leading 1-0, and Al Najjar will look to give his team the lead. And he does as he finds that hole down the middle. Big shot here for Corioso. Steve fires it home. Best shot of the match so far for Corioso, and maybe that will get him started as he is now tied it up at three here in game number two. Al Najjar. And able to go off a man and in. It's match point for Najjar and Mosher. They're just a goal away from the No Pro Doubles final. And Corioso will pick this loose ball up. Steve. Again, fans on that effort. Gets picked up by Najjar. Al Najjar, N-A-J-J-A-R. Al has a chance to close out the match right here and send his team to the final. He sets up the pull shot and calls timeout. Al Najjar will put it into play, shooting against Steve Corioso and looking for victory. Najjar tried to go inside, and there's Corioso to make the block. See if Steve stays back there to shoot it. It looks like he will, and he's a very good shooter, very good goalie. Always has been. Shot down the middle, blocked by Najjar's five rod, and it comes back to Corioso. Another shot, and it's Najjar digging it out here. Again, for the win. And Najjar able to fire it home. There it is. In two straight games, Al Najjar, Tom Mosher defeat Dana Thompson and Steve Corioso to advance to the final of No Pro Doubles.